Hello everyone, it's Teaching Dreamer. Today we are gonna work on this one. It's this castle cutaway from Artsy. And I work on 40 count mall linen with 2 over 1 half stitches. And I just change the way work on it. You can see I do it with parking method, and it's 10 by 10 square diagonal. It's like how I work on one of my heaviness design, the Beach Compass Bounty. And I love this way because it goes pretty fast. Actually, faster than I thought. And it goes smoother. Most importantly, it's enjoyable. I really love this way. And you know I prefer cross country, but this method actually changed my thought. I'm so happy I used this way, and you can see this is my old method. It's like a 10 by 10 square column, and I stitch it at 2 pages long and then park into the next one. This is the old method, and this is a new one, and I think I would just keep using this way because it's fun. I really love it. I'm also changing some other full coverage project to this method, and actually you can see the progress, how fast it could be. You can see from here to here, this diagonal shape. This is the progress of these past 2 days. I work on since yesterday. Yeah, yesterday from today, and it's how much I have done. And I'm so happy that I've almost finished this tree because I have been working on this tree for so long, and I kind of getting tired of it. You can see I start working on the sky. I really love this part because there's only one or two colors in the sky. It's very easy because just one or two colors. I just keep stitching. I don't need to, count on something. And recently, I have been receiving a question from you guys, and you asked me, is any cross stitching program I'm using, or I just read a paper chart? I have been using Pattern Keeper for 4 months, and I run it on my laptop because I don't have an Android device. And before that, I used an app called Easy PDF Reader on my iPad. And basically, you can do what you need to do for just like a highlighting. And you probably can search some such symbols, but I don't know. I don't know why I never try that function. Maybe I will test it maybe someday I can do a tutorial how to use this program as a replacement if you don't have Android for Pattern Keeper. I'm actually still using it on my iPad if I don't stitch in front of my laptop. That's my backup program to read the chart. So, today we are gonna start from here. How I use this, how I stitch this method is I do 10 by 10 square and then from button to the top, it goes diagonal from button to the top, like finish this one and then move on to next one and next one. Yeah, every time I start a new square, I will start from, I will finish this parking thread first, and I will do it from the button of the one that's closest to the button of the square, so that other thread will not get in my way. And then I finish parking thread, and then I stitch a new thread. Yeah, that's how I using this method. So let's start stitching.